Welcome to NAFC-TV's Moving Forward. I'm Diane Williamson. Last year, we told you about Floyd Central High School's band director, Harold Yankey, being recognized with an Excel Award by WHAS Television. This year, he's earned more recognition, this time by his peers. He's been named the Indiana Bandmaster of the Year.
The Indiana Bandmaster of the Year. There's a Bandmaster's fraternity that's a national fraternity called Phi Beta Mu, and each year they present two awards. Their Hall of Fame, usually for retired band directors that have made a contribution, and then the Band Director of the Year, which is sort of for the year, but also a lot for your career. Well, it's very humbling, tremendously humbling, because first of all, when I look at the list of the people on there, we've got many band directors that have won state championships, multiple state championships, people that are published composers that are very famous, people that have done so many things that I'm just kind of wondering, what am I doing on this list? They seem to think I belong there, and it's it's a tremendous honor because it's my peers that are doing it. You didn't compete for it, you couldn't apply for it, you couldn't do anything on your own. It's presented because people feel you deserve that recognition, and that is tremendously rewarding.
Harold says good teachers are always learning, and he's really hit his stride.
I feel like I'm doing my best work here when I've reached my 50s. And I think that's an important thing for people to understand about teachers is we learn too. And I've had 27 years of learning how to do this job, and I think I'm finally getting the hang of it at the level of people that I really admire.
You'd think somebody with his love of music would be out performing every weekend. Not so.
A lot of times for me to be involved in music outside the classroom is difficult because it takes up a tremendous amount of time. I have played in the IUS concert band. I've played in the River City Brass Band. I try to play, listen to music as much, but right now with my sons being in band, I listen to them play on other things. I'm help conduct with several people, the Floyd County Youth Symphony. So that takes up another night. So I don't actually get to play. Most of my experience is with students and conducting them.
Obviously, his time conducting students has been well spent. Can you believe Greenville Elementary School is turning 75? It doesn't look a day over 30. And they're celebrating at their annual spring festival on Saturday, March 17th from 3 to 7 p.m. This community-wide carnival event will include fun, food, and games for the whole family to enjoy. Activities include inflatables, face painting, mini golf, basketball, and more. You can also take advantage of the wonderful items available in the silent auction, including a Superfecta package from Churchill Downs, a $300 Silver Spoon catering package, Cincinnati Reds and Louisville Bats ticket packages, and much more. Greenville Elementary is located at 7025 Cross Street in Greenville. You can find more information on these and other stories on our website and our Facebook page. You can also follow us on Twitter at NAFC Success. We are always looking for great story ideas, so drop me a line if you have some good news. I'm Diane Williamson. We'll see you next time on Moving Forward.